Okay, this is gonna install cam bearings. Never done this before. It's a tool from George's Garage. They look almost identical to the INA bearings. And again, the shell is the same thing as on the INA bearings. You probably can't see it in this video, but you can't discern it. This is the back side. The side is going to face towards the crankshaft. It's pretty much flat, and it's got the markings on it for, you know, the bearing model, etc. This front is kind of curved. This is going to face outward. So this is going to go on the installer with the letters up, so they wind up back against the crankshaft. Letters are up. The instructions with the George's Garage tool say install or apply a small amount of pressing lube to the outer diameter of the new bearing. So the outside of the shell. Now, I have no idea what pressing lube is really supposed to be. But I've got this Redline assembly lube left over from a project long ago. I'm going to put on the outside of that bearing. Tool with bearing on the engine case using 4 Allen thumb screws. Looks like this locating pin has a matching spot here on the tool. From reading the Harley manual, it sounds like the Harley tool is either the same or almost the same as this. That bearing is going where it's supposed to go.
see that's about how much motion it has.
It says carefully turn the threaded shaft inward until the bearing aligns and bore.
I'm just going to leave this loose for a second until I figure out exactly what this is going to do.
Wanted to get a flashlight and look in here.
Pretty much can't see anything.
Carefully tighten the threaded shaft until the tool contacts the engine case. So 3/4.
Tell what's going on, by feel, or by looks.
Bearing fell off the end.
Nice.
I guess the trick is to make sure that this
assembly is threaded through far enough that the bearing is at least touching the side of the case. Come off of there right at the end. Should have noticed that wasn't on there when I was looking at it before, but didn't happen. Well, you can't learn from the mistakes of others. Flashlight died. Alright. I think it's probably pretty important to eyeball this thing. There's enough up and down variation on the shaft, but seems like it can miss the line. Thank you. Okay.
One down.
Stuff like that with the bearing falling off is just right for getting you distracted. Make sure when, if that happens, that the bearing goes back on with the letters facing towards the crankcase. Good.
So, this thing needs to be disassembled. When you're setting it up, thread it about an inch and a half through. Putting this thing together. Okay. I threaded the threaded rod about an inch and a half through and then threaded the bearing holder on to the end of that. This thing is two pieces, not clear to me why. Maybe just so we can fit different ends on there or something. So, letters are going to go towards the ends, away from the plate, towards the crankcase. That just sits on there real loose, so no wonder it falls off. One trick that I've used things like that before is put a bunch of bearing grease in the middle because it's pretty sticky. But I don't really want to start this bike up with new cams and bearing grease on there. I'd rather have this assembly lube and oil. So I don't want to grease those. So here we go again. Much better.
Bearing's still there. Probably should put bearing grease on that. Had some graphite block stuff, and that feels like way too thin. Bottom out, it's not supposed to be tight.